Glory, hallelujah. Oh, you know, if you had not believed to see the goodness of the Lord, hallelujah, in the land of the living, hallelujah. Show yourself strong, Father, hallelujah. Glory, mighty, you are in battle. Hallelujah, on my behalf, on your behalf, hallelujah. Glory, so why should I be quiet? My hope's in God, hallelujah. Glory, that's the glory and the lifter of my head. Glory, hallelujah. Many a time they have said, O Lord, there is no help for me in God. But thou, O Lord, how many are saying? But thou, O Lord, are a shield for me, my glory, and the lifter of my head. Hallelujah. Glory. I lay me down and I slept. I awake. The Lord sustained me. Hallelujah. I'm still living. Glory, hallelujah. I'm still alive. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Oh, how they said there's no hope for him and God. Hallelujah. No way. Hallelujah. Don't see how. Hallelujah. But thou, O Lord, are a shield for me. My glory and the lifting of my head. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Can I get the church to say thank you, Lord? Glory. Can I get a believer to say thank you, Lord? Someone that knows the power of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. What offering shall I bring? Hallelujah to the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. What should I render unto God for all of these benefits toward me? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. What offering should I bring? Well, God bless you. Hallelujah. I can do 30 more minutes and might walk on these pews. If I get myself built up on my most holy faith. Hallelujah. Praying in the Holy Ghost. Yeah, my voice of glory to God. Hallelujah. Man, if you haven't prayed this week in the Holy Ghost, I'm going to hurry up. Glory, utter something. Hallelujah. My spirit prayed. Hallelujah. But my understanding is unfruitful. Yeah, my name, voice. Hallelujah. Take advantages of my privileges in Christ. Hallelujah. Glory. He didn't speak in an unknown tongue, speak mysteries. Hallelujah. You know, he's talking to God. Hallelujah. How many like that conversation? Truly my fellowship is with the Father, with his Son Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory. Worship God in the Spirit, not in the latter. Hallelujah. But in the Spirit. Hallelujah. Speak mysteries. Well, we thank God for this evening. Praise God. We're going to be in the hands of capable apostle, evangelist. How should we say this? Doctor, common man, still amongst the people. Brother Wayne. Help us out this evening. Praise God. He's going to bring to us as the Lord instructs him in the lesson. So let's all receive him. Say amen. Amen.
You have a stool for you, brother. Work. Take advantage of it.
Take off, but thank God for you having a heart. seek after the things of God.
That's right.
Just pressing on, because without you being here, you know, I just keep preaching to these walls here again. To myself, okay. Glad somebody's here. And you probably noticed, I probably get a chance to finish Sunday. And I guess Pastor probably noticed too, so give me another opportunity to share with you. Because truly I believe this is something that, you know, God put in my heart to share. And, you know, through, like I say, a conversation with another person at the time, it just seemed like, you know, like I said, we had read the scripture, I think maybe probably last Wednesday or one of Wednesday night in Bible study. We just kind of read through it, but, you know, like I said, a conversation with somebody else, and I'm sure Chip was described by how they, something they had said, and it reminded them how they died in faith. Some of the old patriarchs that have read in Hebrews 11, having not received the promise. And the person responded and said, well, what kind of God is that you serve? And will seemingly make a promise, and then he don't fulfill it. And from the standpoint, it just almost seems as though that's the way it is, but it's far from that. You know, we know our God is able. But our scripture says he's more than able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we think or even can ask. So if he's able to perform whatever promise he made, and all scripture says all his promises are yea, and amen, so be it in him. And he's not like man, short, come up short, make promises they don't keep, tell you one thing, you know, and don't do it. When God made a promise, he's able to back up and fulfill it. But the other thing, is according to your faith. You know, you might be asking him something, but do you have the faith to believe in that what you're asking for? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And sometimes we feel like things don't materialize like we desire. And we feel like, well, I know, as God is shortchanging and you become frustrated, that's what this particular person that I was talking to seemed to say. You know, God make a promise and not able to fulfill, or allow you to, just, you have to remember, like, you know, the promises that he had made to both of God's, and he is, you know, very strict regarding his word. He's not going to change anything, or, you know, just conform to our way of thinking, what we might believe. I mean, we got to conform to what he has said and what he has spoken. And he rely on us, you know, us to be obedient to him and whatever he'll call us to do. And so many times he might, you know, put things before us and speak to our heart for a particular task. But we kind of have been trained ourselves to put God's voice in the background. Don't hear it. Ignore it. And yet the scripture said, why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not what I say? Hallelujah. I mean, he required obedience of this. And I think the majority of his promises is contingent on you being obedient to him. Hallelujah. If you be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. That's his word.
Amen.
Hey, Brother Wayne, they make that kind of promise. I mean, I'm just telling you what he said in his word. And he's able to stand behind that which he has spoken out. Hallelujah. He said, heaven and earth may fail, but his word shall not fail. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But if we can stay in faith, you know, and that's the whole essence of what I was speaking of, regardless if you come into whatever God has promised you, you must stay in faith. The Bible says to him to the end, the same shall be saved. A lot of people started out in this walk, confessing, believing, you know, God. But at the same time, they get faint in the heart because maybe their circumstances, unfulfilling the dreams, circumstances in their life, seem like things not working together. And they just say, forget it, it's not working. Hallelujah. I'm reading what I'm saying because I have seen it happen in people's lives. And I have seen it sometimes. Do I get frustrated? Oh, yes. Brother Mike, I've gotten frustrated. Disappointment? Yes. I've gotten disappointed. You know. And most time, my disappointment comes when somebody tells me something, they don't do it. I mean, that frustrates me a little bit. I really do. Because I put confidence in that person's word that they're going to do what they said. But somehow or another, in the house of God, with our mouth, we say something and make a commitment, but we don't feel like we should honor it. Hallelujah. But when it comes to God, what he said, he's able to perform. And a lot of time in our life, like I said, these things don't materialize because he is expecting something from us. Now, I believe, you know, this is what I believe regarding healing because the Bible says he paid it. That's part of the benefit package. Hallelujah. The Bible says he took and he bore my infirmities. He bore them on the cross on my behalf. Now, I must exercise faith according to what his word says. Now, these things do come to my body, but I have the right and the privilege of the child of God to resist, to speak to it. That's basically the principle of what Jesus did when the enemy came and tempted him and pointed out different things that he was wanting to do to get him to submit unto what he was speaking to do. If you are the saint, the son of God, to get you to doubt what you have and who you are.
That's right.
Hallelujah. These pains that come to your body. Glory to God. I mean, how do you confront them? Hallelujah. Sometimes I know the commercial is bombarded about telling us run to the medicine cabinet. But is your first reaction is by his stripes I'm healed? Hallelujah. You have to build yourself up in faith according to what God's word when these things come.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And resist the devil with all that you have within you. Lord, your word said, this is your promise. According to your word, be it so unto me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But as we read in Hebrew 11, it said, these all died in faith, not having received the promise. Hallelujah. But having seen them afar off, were persuaded of them, embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims of this earth. And like I said, most time our promises or what we believe in God for has to do with what's going on in the earth.
Yes.
We spend most of the petition, God, I need.
Mm-hmm.
God, I want. Help me, Lord, in this situation. Which, like I said earlier Sunday, I understand it. I found myself doing the same thing. But you have to understand there is something you require of us. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Because he will speak to your heart and give you a task. He will tell you to do it. He will tell you to go to somebody. He will tell you to speak to someone, encourage someone. But a lot of times we'll try to ignore it. We'll try to fast it off. We'll try to eat it off. Try to go shopping. Get busy more than y'all, watch the game. Doing all sorts of things other than what he has spoken in your heart to do. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But he requires obedience. Obedience is better than what? Sacrifice. And sometimes, like I was sharing the story about what took place on my job, I didn't get to finish that. I left the wrong impression. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I mean, the essence of that story that I was sharing was that, like I said, my supervisor wanted something, and there was something I was wanting. Like I said, I was wanting my name taken off this negative response, but yet he was wanting me to launch an investigation on what took place. But I didn't really want to get in the mix of it because of some conflicts among others. In order for me to get in there, it just made a situation worse. But because, you know, he placed a responsibility on me, I had to get, you know, go in the midst of my coworkers. Glory to God. But I was just kind of resisting it because I felt like I was right. And he wrote. I knew the policy. Of course, I mean, he did too. But it was something he wanted. There was something that was required of me from him. And to make a long story short, in the middle of our conversation, because I presented him the information that he was wanting, he said, by the way, I'm going to remove your name off this ticket. That's all I was wanting. But there was something required of me being obedient to him. Because like I said, I'm still been trying to read his mind, and he probably tried to read my mind because of what each of us wanted, and he already knew what I was wanting before I didn't ask. Because before all of him, I could say, he said, by the way, I'm going to renew your name on this negative list. Hallelujah. But the same thing with God, there is something that he requires of us. Yes. A lot of times we read the scripture, whatsoever we desire, when we pray, believe, and ye shall have them. Glory to God. That's God's promises. And he able to make it come to pass. But there is contingencies on that. Hallelujah. I mean, you have to position yourself to walk in that where God can move and you move on your behalf in according to that scripture. That you walk in obedience to him. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Well, praise him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And like I said, a lot of times when things don't materialize like we desire, we begin to get upset, mad, frustrated. And then we'll take things out of our own hand that, I'm going to help you, Lord. Since you can't get it to me quick enough, I'm going to go out here and figure out how to help you out. Because I really want this thing. I want this thing to be a part of my life to so much to the extent that I'm going to be young what you want me to do, and go ahead on attaining it. And then we find ourselves that this thing that we have gotten ourselves into wasn't of God, he didn't sanction it, and you got trouble on your hand. Because scripture says, the blessing of the Lord make it rich and add no sorrow. Because you took up in your own self to make this move, now you have sorrow with it. Because if everything that you desire to have, there's no more giving you that joy that you have. It's giving you trouble. Because you didn't do it according to what it's worth. You didn't do obedience to what he had called you to do. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise your Father. Hallelujah. And Hebrews 10:35. It says, to cast away now the cup. Let's go there. I got it written down partially. But Hebrews 10:35 says, cast not away therefore your confidence, which have great recompense to reward. For ye have need of patience. Patience. And after you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. Like I say, you see, might. And I always see might. Is you might get it and you might not get it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because is it anybody in here that you would believe in God something that you have gotten every single time? But you still stand in faith for that. But for all that to come to pass, you must find yourself doing God's will. The only person I know that did that was Jesus. Hallelujah. He was obedient to God every time. And every time and whatever he prayed for, he asked the Father for, he got it. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. But we can get there, I believe, by the grace of God. Because I see in Paul's life, you know, he had to go through a whole lot. And I remember some of the things that, how Paul was. You talk about a man that, I guess I call him like a modern day Bounder. I mean, because on the scene where the Christian were, he would actually pay to arrest Christians. They'll haul him off to jail. What a job. Hallelujah. What a job to get paid to haul off Christians. And they paid him for it. Thank you, Lord. But somehow or another, God dealt with him. Even though on the way to Damascus, he spoke to him. And we say sometimes that, you know, God won't put things on you or anything negative on you. But he blinded Saul. Hallelujah. So Saul, why do you persecute me? And he was blind. We get to turn around. But the thing that I, remarkable thing that I see, Paul called him Lord. So that tells me Saul had an experience in where he hung around a Christian and heard the word enough. God would already have been dealing with him to get him to recognize his voice. Because you have to remember this man is blind. Yes. So he cannot see. Yes. So that means he recognizes who's talking to him. Hallelujah. And that's where we had to come into play is we had to recognize when he's talking to you. Hallelujah. And when you recognize he's talking to you, whatever he tells you, as Mary said, do it. Because in that you find the joy of the Lord become your strength. The thing that you desire of him, he just gives them to you. But in fact, he go beyond that what you desire that you ask of him. Because before we can get the desire of our heart that we are believing for, we got to walk in obedience to him. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But it required, like I say, something of us. And you can't shake it off going here to hear that he's speaking to your heart about. And I really, I'm totally convinced he's speaking to our heart. And some of us, we say, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. They told us years ago that when you don't know what you're supposed to be doing, and I don't know if Pastor Hill or who that said that, start out by ushering. And that's what I started out doing, ushering. Hallelujah. And through that commitment of being just showing up on Sunday and hanging, like I said, hanging around the saints, coming out here in prayer. When the older saints are here, the Tillises, praise God, the Reeds, all these people that prayed and labored. Because I remember after the Bible study, instead of us dismissing and go home, we came down here to the altar. That was over and over again on Wednesday night Bible study. Hallelujah. The saints come and pray and saw God even further. But nowadays, we ready to go home. I better leave that wrong. Hallelujah. But if you want to know, as Paul said, he pressed toward the mark of the high calling which in Christ Jesus, you want to know what a mark is. You ain't going to know it. Get home watching TV. It's going to require you, you know, spending time in the Word and seeking Him and being amongst the people. There's so many times that I come here during Bible study that Pastor Hill be preaching, even on Sunday, different scriptures that will come to me. I would write them down. It just seemed like it just, you know, it may be something different what he might be speaking of altogether. But he would say a scripture. I don't know why and what it's about. But I would just stop and write it down. Then later on, Pastor Hill would have me to do something. And it has something to do with what he asking me to do. But being in the middle of what's going on, in the anointing that's in the church, it protects us and keeps us. Don't stay away. The Bible says, as you see that day approaching, but forsake not assembling of yourselves among the believers. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come together, even, the Bible says, even the more. Because there is something he's going to impart unto us. There's something he's going to speak to our heart to encourage us. Because there are so many things that are attacking us, they're going to get us discouraged. You got to be somewhere that you hear the word of God to be encouraged. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. For 36, for ye have need of patience, for after you have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. For a little while, and he that shall come will come and will not tarry. And 30 is now the just shall live by faith. But if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. Thank you, Lord. But we are not of them who draw back on tradition, but of them that believe to the saving of the soul. Thank you, Father. So we don't want to be there when God speaks to us. So sometimes stand up and just pray. Because that's the thing I remember about, like I said, Sister Jackson, and I would used to come on Tuesday. I used to have Tuesday and Wednesday morning prayer. I'm just kind of showing you how, you know, God, you know, encourages you, motivates you to do things and go beyond your normal of yourself. And they would have, this one was like probably about 20 year old maybe. So he said, bunk people can't be saved. They can't walk in, things have changed. We're in a different time zone and all of this here. But I know the dispensation that I was coming up as I was 19, 18 years old. Actually, I came to this church probably back in 79 or 80, and I was about 19 years old when I first got saved here. And God dealt with my heart and began to draw me in. But I had to stay. And amongst the people here, the saints of God, actually coming during the week of day, with Sister Jackson, them Tuesday and Thursday prayer. She encouraged me. Then sometimes she would give them the mic, well, then I didn't pray. Well, somebody's scared to know what to say. But over time, God began to release the prayer from my life. And the same thing with your life. As you yield yourself unto Him, praise God. Whatever that you are lacking, He will put within you the ability to do the task of what He has set before you. Like I said, never have I ever thought about, you know, I will be standing here before you. No. You know, I'd rather just take my seat right there where you are. I mean, most of the time you hear, you know, they debating scriptures and stuff, you probably won't even hear me say anything. The pastor will pick me out of the middle of it. I mean, you know, they just somehow that it just ain't in me at that time. But when God give me something to do, and I know, and I'm so sure about what He tell me to do, I just get excited about it. I mean, and then you know, the fear is nowhere to be found. Because I know what the word says, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Glory to God. And whatever God has set before you, you can do it. But you have to step out in faith, believing, and trusting God that he's going to put the right words in your mouth when you say them. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And sometimes people say, and I like confirmation. And then he does show up in that. A lot of time, well, I'm not sure about what I was speaking. Somebody would say something, and it would just bear witness in my spirit immediately. This is what I'm supposed to do. But the bear witness of, or the confirmation is what he already told you, and you already have that thing in your heart. You've got to confirm to it already, regardless if anybody say anything. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And like I said, Paul lived a life that was dedicated to the Lord. And some of the things that I read in there, what he went through. And like I said, this man faced many challenges of life, many sufferings. And 1 Corinthians 4:9, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And it said, for I think that God has set forth us, the apostles last, as it was appointed unto death. For we are made a spectacle unto the world, and to angels, and to men. And sometimes you feel like, but you know, who you are, Christians, you feel like you're just being left behind. I mean, people poke fun at you. I mean, you begin to see what other people have in their life, and maybe bigger house or a newer car or what have you. And it just is have a tendency to bother you somewhere. And you begin to think that sometimes you might be maybe something going on within your body physically or mentally or what have you. And you begin to feel like you're alone. God, do you see me, what I'm going through? And you feel like I'm the only one in the whole world is going through this. Look at the world, they're going and having fun, and woe is me. Glory to God. But here this man, Paul, Apostle Paul, saying that he felt like his apostles, they were the last. It was set to a point unto death, for we are made a spectacle unto the world, and to the angels, and to men. For we are fools for Christ's sake. I mean, you just seem foolish sometimes, don't it? Serving God. Doing what you're doing and what you believe in. And you see, these folks, they seem like they don't care nothing about God, don't think nothing about God. And they seem like they have more than you going on when you talk to them. Oh, boy. But if you just keep on talking to them. Hallelujah. You will find out something totally different story. Hallelujah. But just because you have Christ in you, that don't mean the trouble don't show up at your doorstep. That you don't have challenges. But to see the difference between them and you, you have Christ on the inside of you. Hallelujah. To help you through your trial. There is no temptation. Hallelujah. That God won't that comes your way, that He will allow you to bear. But with that temptation, He will provide a way of escape if it gets too hard. So you crumbling under the circumstances and under the situation should not be. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Because I have seen Him come through time and time again. I mean, He showed up, it just seemed like it is the last day, last hour. I was about to feel like I'm going to give up and quit. Man, God, what do you need to come through on this thing? I mean, the pressure, it'd be rough. But somehow or another, He showed up. Hallelujah. He changed it for my good. He called it to work out for my advantage. And then I have a testimony. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We are fools for Christ's sake, but For ye are wise in Christ. We are weak, but ye are strong. Ye are honorable, but we are despised. Even unto this present hour, we are both hungry, but also how? Hungry? And thirst? And naked? I'm running around with the same clothes on. No change of clothes. They ain't talking like butt naked, y'all. He still running around the same clothes on. He ain't allowed clothes to change. Hallelujah. And are buffeted and have no certain dwelling place. Now, don't we all feel a little bit more better about our situation? Hallelujah. When you leave here, I believe everybody here got a dwelling place. Yeah. Even Jesus himself, fox will have hole, and bird have nest, but the Son of Man have nowhere to lay his head. Right. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And verse 12 say, and laborers working with our own hands, being reviled, we blessed, but we being persecuted, we suffer. Being defamed, we entreat, we are made as filth of the world. Glory to God. And are the offscouring of all things unto this day. Thank you, Lord. So in the end, another 2 Corinthians 11:23. I'm just telling you that you're not alone in what you went through or what you might be going through. But Paul, he was convinced that I'm going to press to the mark. To the mark of the high calling which is in Christ Jesus. And he said, these light affliction with this world and not to be compared to the glory that he's going to receive later. So he has something else in his view other than what are the things that he's might be going through. And that's what we had to get coming focus of. Something else, God's word, praise God, have heaven in our view and not all these things that's going around, us and causing us pain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 11:23. Thank you, Father. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. And verse 22, are they ministers of Christ? I speak as fool. I am more in labor, more abundantly in strife, and above measure in prison, more frequently, death often. So this man was thrown in prison and he had threats on his life. And of the Jews, 5 times received our 40 stripes, saved 1, 25 thrice was I beaten with rod, 1 with a stone, 3 suffered shipwreck, a night and day I have been in the deep, in journeys often, in perils of water, in perils of robbers, and pearls of my own countrymen, and pearls by the heathen, and pearls in the city, pearls in the wilderness, pearls in the sea, pearls among false brethren. See, like me, had every way he went, he would seem like afraid in trouble. But he pressed on anyhow. Hallelujah. And that's the thing we have to do, is press on regardless what the enemy may be bringing forth from us. We have to keep the faith. We have to stay in faith. And that's the thing that Paul had that testimony. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise your Father. And I had read the scripture in James. Oh, let's go to Hebrews 12:2. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And this is the thing that it says, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Let's talk about Jesus, who, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross. So you have to put some joy before you to endure your trial and your circumstance that you're going through. Hallelujah. He's despised and ashamed, and then sit down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him that endureth such contradiction of sinners against himself, lest ye be wearied and faint in your own mind. So you consider what he had to go through. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The affliction that he suffered. I mean, he had to get heaven in focus more than what his circumstances and situation were. He was, the Bible said he was obedient even to the death of the cross. Whatever all that God had set before him, praise God, he finished. Thank you, Jesus. And even Paul said he did the same likewise. He said, I have finished the course. Hallelujah. I have kept the faith. He said, now there are the crown of righteousness laid up before me. So he had to keep his focus on what reward they don't receive, not what he was going to get down here. Glory to God. And that's had to be our focus of what we're going to receive when we go to heaven or when we rapture or whatever the case may be. I guess, so what if I don't, you know, sure, I'd like to have a bigger home and all this stuff and nice car, you know, some you probably see my little car ride around here. I'm just as happy with it as it be. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because God has still been good to me. I mean, I have something a lot more than these just things. Hallelujah. He has healed my body. I mean, he has given me joy. He has given me peace. And he supplied all of my needs according to his riches. And glory to Christ Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So we have to keep in mind to keep heaven in our view. Once that you come into whatever God has promised you, that you're going to keep the faith. You're going to endure hardness as a good soldier. You're not going to allow your circumstance or your situation or the unfavorable thing or even people to speak against you to cause you to draw back, to give faint heart. Thank you, Lord. Because you would think that Paul, being the same person that had enough power and authority in God, that he would say, I'm betwixt between the two. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That means to decide whether I should go on the glory or whether I should stay here. Money can't buy it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This man knew God enough in whose hand he would be able to trust to. And God had left it up to him to make the final decision. And he said, it's going to be expedient for me to be here for your sake. I have made that choice that I'm going to stay here with you. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. What power. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, praise the Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And James 4, 1 and 3, I've got to read it again, and I'll be done. I've got a different translation on this little phone here. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Over the New Living Translation, which, you know, is pretty close to the same thing as Hebrews, but had a few little words in there to kind of bring it out a little bit. Like I said, in the middle of what you're going through, you get frustrated. And that's why it said in James 4 and 1, it said, what is causing the quarrel and the fights among you? Though they come from evil desires or war within you, something going on in believers to get what they want to get faith. And heart. You want what you don't have. So you scheme to kill to get it. You try to figure out a way, some kind of way. I'm going to get what I want. God, you ain't got it to me yet. I've been waiting. 3 years have passed. 2 years have passed. I've still been waiting, God. It seems like you need some help. want what you don't have, you scheme and kill to get it, you are jealous of what others have, but you can't get it, so you fight and wage war to take it away from them. Yet you don't have what you want because you don't ask God for it. And even when you ask, you don't get it because your motives are wrong. You want only what will give you pleasure. Thank you, Father. Meaning you want it for your own desire. But even after you got what you want, still God is coming to you. I have something for you. I need you to do. But yet we don't hear it. The Bible said, Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice. Glory to God. And we are the sheep of his pastor. So that means his sheep recognize his voice when he speaks to them. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because you think in terms of your children that you give tasks. Sometimes you tell them, you know, whatever, clean them. You know, I have one of them that they hated doing dishes. I mean, just literally hate doing the dishes. You know, which I could never understand because it ain't that complicated, not that easy to do. That hard to do. But I mean, but she really hated to do it. She's supposed to take a whip and seemingly, you know, to do the dishes. And then if they did get around, it took them so long to get around to doing it, they would take, you know, several hours just washing a few dishes. And it's sometimes like this, God, he speaks to our heart to do something. We take so long to get around to doing it. But yet we say, Lord, I need you now. But we need to get in a position where we are willing and obedient. We need to speak to us. We move and we act. Got to remember, he said, his sheep hears his voice. Hallelujah. That's what we need to pray, Lord. Give us ears to hear you and recognize you when you speak to us. Because sometimes, somebody's life is dependent on you. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Your obedience could be tied to someone else's soul salvation. Thank you, Lord. But we continue to make petitions. God, I want. Give me love. Hallelujah. But then when he speaks to us, we drag our foot. Tell us to do something this week. It's 2 more weeks later. We decide we go do it. I do it, Lord. Okay, now I do it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Well, praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father. I think that just about it. I pray that it wouldn't be so painful that it did bless somebody. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And Father, we just thank you, Lord God, for your word. We thank you, Lord, for everyone that is here. Lord, I thank you for this opportunity to share, Lord God, with what you have placed in my heart. And I thank you for the one that is here to receive it, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we are your people, and we are the sheep of your pasture, Lord. And Lord, we want to hear from you when you speak to us. Create us, O Lord, a clean heart, a renew a right spirit within us, O God. That we will walk in your way, Father God. And speak those things, Lord, that you desire us to speak. We thank you, Father God, for all that you're doing. And we give you the praise and the glory. We thank you, Lord, for meet every need according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus. Whatever they may be, Father God. But Lord, we put our trust in you and not in man, Lord God. Lord God, that you are able to do this even above all we think or ask according to the power that it work within us. We know the power working both hallowed the will of your due and your good pleasures, which have been worked through the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord God, we do have the Holy Spirit abiding within us, teaching us your ways and your statutes, Father God. We thank you, Father God, as we move out in you and do those things, Lord, that you have called us doing that what you had asked of us. And Lord, we would do it with joy and with gladness and sing of heart. Because you've been so good to us, O God. in the keeping of our family and protection of God, hallelujah, even when we don't even know, hallelujah. Every morning we wake up new mercies. We thank you, Lord, for your many benefits. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Even our jobs might have annual benefits once a year. But Lord, you daily load us up with benefits. Hallelujah. For you said it is your good pleasure to give us the kingdom. But your kingdom is not meat and drink, but it is joy in the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. We thank you, Lord, for giving us those things that we really need, O Lord, to accomplish whatever you have set before us. For we shall run this race, God, with patience, knowing, God, hallelujah, that you are with us and you are in us. We have the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, guide and lead us, and we shall finish this course in all that you have set before us. And we thank you, Father God, and we give you the praise, and we seek first your kingdom and all of its righteousness, and everything else shall be added unto us. And we thank you and rejoice in you, Lord God. For truly, God, this is the day that you have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. And we are thankful, Father God, as we leave this place, but not your presence. We thank you, Lord, for your protection and loving kindness, O Lord. Direct us and leading and guiding us into all truth. And Lord, until we return again, Father God, we give you the praise. We thank you for blessing our pastors, O God. Hallelujah. Strengthen their body, encourage them, O God. Minister to them, O Father. In the name of Jesus, let them return, God, we feel refreshed. Hallelujah, to move forward. We thank you, Lord God, as a people of God, God, we will stand with them, O God, in this time and carry out the mission that you have set before us. And Lord, let us say yes to your will. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, we give you the praise and we give you the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Well, praise God. We just...